All right, I want to check. It's almost a month. This amazing machine. Let's see what we get out of it. Get some coins. And the star of the show. Oh no, it opened the star of the show.
What's up, you guys? This is Chris for Hustle and Bustle. Hope you enjoyed that episode. It's my collection for the month of March. I'm going to include the ATMs, the coin pushers, the gumball machines, and the claw machines. Hope you enjoy, guys. Hit like and subscribe because I'm going to appreciate that tremendously, and you're going to help me grow this channel. With all that said, let's continue with the video.
All right, guys. I don't know if you guessed correctly. We got 100, 200, 275, 290, 291. And now, well, we're going to give the owner half of the profit, which is 33%. We take 33% for the merchandise, and then the rest is... Oh, wait, we got coins. Shit, never mind. All right, so we got 100, 200, 275, 290, 295, 3, 305, and 25 cents. $16.75. Woof! Oh my god, I left the camera to charge here, and I went to the bike shop. I made $10.50 from the bike shop, and the barber shop next door, $33.75. That's insane. 30 to 75. Perfect. All right, coin pusher time.
So I don't know if you found that out about me, but I forget a lot of things. And here I forgot my scale, which I use to measure the weight of the coins, so I don't need to do this and count them. But the owner was very kind and helped out, so that was good.
Okay, all in all, we made $160.25 from a coin pusher. Damn it, shut up. And 160 and 25 cents, we multiply that by 40% because that's how much we give to the owner, and that's $64. So 160 minus 64, we made $96 for us only from the coin pusher. It's been 1 month. Unfortunately, she sold the place, and in a month or month and a half, we gotta get out of here. So I gotta find a new spot. Right, we are the account that we have ATM, the coin pusher, and a little candy machine here. How the star of the show performed.
Finding the right key for my machine is like finding a normal girl to date nowadays.
Not bad, actually. That's a lot.
In case you're wondering, yes, this is the most professional way to collect your coins from your account.
As you can tell, they're renovating a little bit, so this account is not fully functional, but we got the full line of ATM cups and a pusher. Still, we're gonna do a pull, but they're not functioning right now.
Side note, I actually made a new installation of another machine that has been in storage unit for a month, and a toy machine or capsule machine, whatever you call it. And in true Christian fashion, if you know me, I went above and beyond to explain exactly what's going on the account. So there you go.
So guys, this account took a lot into the making, maybe a month and a half. The owner was not ready to receive the machine after he said he is. For that reason, I had to get a storage unit to store the machine because it could not go inside my house. It was too big.
That's what she said.
So I can basically cancel the storage unit now.
Okay, okay. No one cares. Let's go back to the collection.
So this location, we put $11.50, which is pretty good. I gave the customer some free candy because I know they appreciate that. But yeah, let's go to the next one. So I'm here in front of one of the locations that is actually closing, and we have to pull the machine out. Unfortunately, it was an okay location. I think I pulled like $10 a month, but fortunately they're closing, and I have to pull the machine out.
And of course, I have to leave in a classic Christian fashion, as usual, spilling, dropping and forgetting stuff.
Good thing I did not spill the coffee.
It's always fun to go to the bank with a bag full of quarters like a baller. And yeah, we went to the bank, cashed out the quarters. They were quite a substantial amount. Now, the day after this, I went actually and cashed out one of the coin pushers because it is in a city that I don't live in. It's in a different city. And I'm gonna include a photo because why not? And I did the last claw machine and the last candy machine. Now, instead of me going through all of the accounts, because I have 18 accounts of gumball machines, now there are 17 without that that actually closed. So instead of doing this, I'm just going to tally up the results. From the gumball machines for the month of March, we have $159.49 spread over 18 machines, which is $8.86 per machine. I did have, I think, two machines that had only 50 cents in them, but this is what you can expect on average. We had some high performers, which are $32, $33, if I remember correctly. And we had another one that had around 20, but we also had, you know, a couple that had, one had $1.75 and another two had 50 cents. So on average, I expect, you know, $10. I have in total of 75 machines that only, like I said, 18 are installed, and I'm going to be looking to install the rest of them because 75 machines, $10 each, is $7.50 a month, which is great. Okay, moving on to the coin pushers. On the coin pushers, we made a profit of, oh, and by the way, the gumballs, this is gross. This is just what we made. That does not account for actual profit because this is the coins we put. We did not minus the cost of candy, which is a topic for another video. But for the coin pushers, we did cash net $500.10, which is great. I do have four accounts. Not all of them have a full month because I recently installed them. They are working and they're all functional. The claw machines are four. One of them is giving me attitude, which is a future video that I want to make. And we made $255.25. This is net. This is gross. That means that from that, half of it, give or take half. I mean, toys don't really cost 33% of it, but they're about, you know, 20 to 35%, let's say. But we tell the owners that they're 33% of the price, and we split the remaining 66%. So gross $255.25, which is not bad. I have one full month of the brewery, and then the other two are pretty new, and the fourth one I just installed, so I did not really pull anything out of it. So 255 divided by three, what is that? On average, $80 and change. But again, like I said, the two new ones, the toy taxi, the yellow ones, they're just 50 cents per play. And the brewery, I have $1 per play, which is toys. And the 50 cents per play ones are pretty new, so they don't really have a full month. And finally, the ATMs did better than last month. Last month, I made $560. And this month, I made $830. And this is net, because this is only my share, of course, not taken out the taxes yet. So all in all, for the month of March, I made $1,744.94, which is not a bad month. Now, how much money I've invested in all that, this will be a topic for a different video because it is quite extensive to cover, you know, how much money I spent on different machinery. And if it's something that interests you guys, please let me know into the comments below. Thank you all very much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this footage and this type of, you know, hustle and bustle every Wednesday. By the way, I did find a place for the coin pusher. I went to a gas station to buy beer, and I just asked, who's the manager? He's like, it's me. And I'm like, all right, do you guys need a coin pusher? And he's like, actually, we've been trying to get one. So the location that I'm moving out of, I actually did find a place for it, which is great. Also, moral of the story is drink more beer. And next week or so, I'm going to be moving the coin pusher there. Maybe I'll film, maybe I won't. I don't think it's such an interesting video to move a coin pusher. And in a classic Christian fashion, I almost forgot for Turo. So let's see how Turo ends. 659 plus 50, so that's $709 for last month, the month of March. So we're gonna add that $709, so the total for the whole month is $2,453.94, so $2,500 give or take. Now for the month of April, I definitely have a little bit more in stock for you guys, and this is not fully booked month. Today's date of recording is April 6th, so I can release the video tomorrow, and I still have more dates to be booked, so let's see how much money I'm gonna make from Turo this month. Also, wait for the story how people smoked weed inside my car and put tint on my window. But yeah, that's it for now, guys. Please help me grow the channel, and easy way to support the channel is to subscribe and like the video. And if you leave a comment with a question, I will reply and respond to that. Thank you very much again, and see you next time. Keep hustling.